I'm Landon Cassill, and you're watching Three Wide Life.
So Landon, before we kind of talk about the whole racing story, I just want to kind of get to know you because you have this unique and fun personality. People love you on social media. Give me the background story.
Well, I was probably, I think the way my mom describes, probably should have been medicated. I was kind of rambunctious, I think, as a kid and had a lot of energy. And I loved soccer through elementary and in middle school. I loved playing soccer. Man, racing really consumed my life from the time, from probably seventh and eighth grade is when it started getting serious in terms of racing a lot. Yeah. And by the time I was in high school, you know, I was traveling so much that there was no time to play soccer. I don't know, I was kind of a typical early 2000s alt kid in high school listening to indie rock and hanging out with band kids, I think. Definitely wasn't a cool kid, that's for sure.
How did the whole racing kind of evolve for you?
It started out my brother and I racing four-wheelers and my dad taking us kind of all over the place riding four-wheelers with each other. And by the time I was 8 years old, that evolved into go-kart racing and actually racing, you know, organized go-kart races in Cedar Rapids at our local track, Hawkeye Downs Speedway. And the go-kart racing between 8 and 12 in itself evolved from, you know, being a Sunday afternoon thing that we did at our hometown to traveling, you know, all over the country to race in organized national touring events. And by the time, you know, I got out of go-kart racing at 12, I started getting into full-size stock cars through my teenage years, and we just always had a drive and determination. Really, I mean, I feel like coming from my dad, that we wanted to find more competition. You know, where can we go to find more people to race? I feel like I never grew up with the mindset of how many trophies can I collect. It was more of who can we race against. We weren't picking races that we could win. We were picking races to find the best person that we could beat. And honestly, more times than not, we didn't beat them. Mm-hmm. But that's, I think, what made me better.
Okay.
Was learning how to race against people that were better than me.
Would you say, though, that your dad has been a big mentor, maybe even your brother, throughout your career to where you are now?
I think my dad and my Uncle Jay are probably my two biggest racing mentors throughout my entire life. Yeah, I mean, we didn't come from a racing family, but we came from a car family. My dad, my family has been in the used car business for their whole lives, and my dad owned a Ford dealership when he was in his early 30s, when I was just when I was really young, and then we've had our used car lot in Cedar Rapids for almost 50 years. So, mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, we've kind of just always been around cars, and my uncle is an absolute gearhead, is probably the smartest mechanic that I've ever seen when it comes to working on cars. So there's always been a lot of motorsport inspiration. I'm just the first generation to actually race.
If you were not driving, what is the job you'd be doing?
I think I probably would have enjoyed fabrication. I think I would have enjoyed body work or aero. If I could go back and change one thing about my 18 to 24 year old years of my career, I wish I would have gotten some sort of engineering degree. Engineering is really cool, the way we use sim programs and basically science to make these cars go faster is pretty fascinating to me.